Morning students, in the previous video we have completed the chapter The Happy Prince. I hope you have revised the chapter also. So students, today in this video we are going to take up the question answers of the chapter. So question number one, why do the courtiers call the prince the happy prince? Is he really happy? What does he see all around him? So students, I am going to give you the guideline of the answer. You can see, he was a prince when he was alive. Being a prince, he never knew sorrow and suffering. So the courtiers call him, but he was not happy in real sense, as his heart could feel the misery of needy people. He saw the miserable conditions of people around him. Now students, question number two, why does the happy prince send a ruby for the seamstress? What does the swallow do in the seamstress house? So the seamstress was tired due to overwork. She was so poor that she could not buy oranges for her little sick son. Her son was thirsty. The happy prince saw the poor lady and her son. He felt pity for them, so he sent a ruby for her. The swallow came to the poor woman's house and laid the ruby on the table beside her. The bird fanned the boy's forehead with wings and flew back to the happy prince. Now students, question number three, for whom does the prince send the sapphires and why? The playwright was very poor. He was incapable of buying food and firewood. The prince sent the sapphires for the playwright so that he could finish a play for the director of the theater in time. The prince sent his second sapphire to a poor match girl. Her matches had fallen into the gutter. She was afraid that her father would beat her for this loss. So he was helped by the prince by sending her the second sapphire. Now students, question number four. What does the swallow see when it was flying over the city? The swallow saw all the categories of people. He found the rich making merry in their beautiful houses and beggars begging sitting at the gates. He also saw a group of wandering children who were poverty stricken. Why did the swallow, next question, question number five. Why did the swallow not leave the prince and go to Egypt? So students, the answer is, at first, the swallow was willing to go to Egypt just after discharging his duty properly. But when he saw prince activities of charity and kindness, he got impressed. On the other hand, now the happy prince had become totally blind due to the deeds of charity. In this condition, he could not leave the prince helpless. He left the idea of going to Egypt and decided to serve the prince. Now students, question number six. What are the precious things mentioned in the story? Why are they precious? So the answer is, the leaden heart of the happy prince and the dead swallow are the two precious things mentioned in the story. They are precious as they did various deeds for the welfare of people and sacrificed their lives for the sake of others. Now students, we have the question form, talk about it. The little swallow says, it is curious but I feel quite warm now. Although it is so cold, have you ever had such a feeling? Share your experience with your friend. You know students, you will write the answer by your own, but still I will give you a little bit guideline. Ki kaise likh sakte ho aap iska answer? Man is a social animal. He is social because he is dependent on others to lead a satisfactory life. In this regard, mutual help is required. Whenever we help others, there is a feeling of satisfaction. Whenever we are helped by others, we feel grateful. It is because helping others is the essence of life. In this chapter, the little swallow feels warmth when he helps the needy people. He does his act of selfless service with utmost dedication and sacrifice. Owing to this selfless service, he becomes satisfied. Yes, I have experienced such a feeling many a time. I believe in helping others. Others too help me whenever I am in need. I help others considering it my duty. I remember the day when I started helping others. Since the day, I feel more confident and have become a successful citizen. I feel the presence of God around me. So students, what you can do? You can write the answer by your own also. You can take help of the guideline I have provided to you. And all the question answers you are supposed to do in your notebook. So students, this is all for today. And other chapter we will take up in the next video. Revise the chapter thoroughly. Do your work neatly. Thank you students. Have a nice day.